John Everett Millais was born in 1829 and showed such prodigious artistic talent that in 1839 he won a Silver Isis Award depicting the Battle of Bannockburn. In the following year, 1840, at the tender age of 11, he passed his probationary term, which entitled him to study for 10 years in the Royal Academy School, and he remained there for 6 years. John Millais' new work, Isabella, was exhibited throughout August 1848 in a prominent room at the Royal Academy and was sold for the asking price of £150. Isabella was exhibited accompanied by stanzas 1 and 21 from John Keats's poem Isabella, or The Pot of Basil, 1820, which together relay the main themes in the poem that Millais wished to explore. The infatuation of Lorenzo for Isabella, his servitude to her two brothers, and the brothers' determination to destroy the lovers' relationship. Mariana is a lady who lives a solitary existence in a moated grange after being rejected by her fiancé Angelo when her diary is lost in a shipwreck. She still has feelings for Angelo and desperately yearns for him. Millais represents her wearing an engagement ring. Millais took as the starting point for his painting of Mariana the poem of the same name that Alfred Tennyson had composed in 1830, derived from Shakespeare's Measure for Measure. The private altar by Mariana's bed in the background suggests that Millais was also making reference to Tennyson's other poem on the subject of Mariana, Mariana in the South, composed in 1832, which presents her desperately calling for help to the Virgin Mary. The layering of literary allusions deepened Millais' exploitation of the tension Mariana experiences between her spiritual and physical desires. Millais shared with Tennyson an extraordinary eye for detail, which serves to heighten the psychological intensity of the scene. A Huguenot was the first of a series of highly successful paintings that focus on the constraints of lovers in situations of civil conflict. The St. Bartholomew's Day Massacre took place in August 1572, when French Catholics, under the leadership of the Duke of Guise, slaughtered thousands of Huguenots, Protestants, in Paris. The Duke of Guise ordered, "When the clock of the Palais de Justice shall sound upon the great bell at daybreak, then each good Catholic must bind a strip of white linen round his arm and place a fair white cross in his cap." Millais' painting shows a Catholic woman entreating her Huguenot lover to escape the massacre by binding a white cloth around his arm to identify him as a Catholic. The tenderness with which he resists indicates he would rather die than renounce his faith. Millais' painting of John Ruskin, the famous critic and writer, was produced between 1853 and 1854, whilst John Ruskin was married to Effie, née Gray. They had been married since July 1848. In the September of 1848, the PreRaphaelite Brotherhood was formed at John Everett Millais' studio in Gower Street. In 1851, Ruskin had published his pamphlet PreRaphaelism that had resulted in a dramatic change of opinion, for the better, towards the new controversial painting movement known as PreRaphaelite, that included such up-and-coming painters as John Millais, Holman Hunt, and Dante Gabriel Rossetti. In 1853, Effie Ruskin sat for Millais' painting, The Order of Release. In the following year, 1854, Effie left John Ruskin, and later that year, Effie's marriage to John Ruskin was annulled on the questionable grounds of Ruskin's impotency. On July the 3rd, 1855, John Millais married Effie, and they went on a month's honeymoon. It should be said of John Ruskin that he was the leading art critic of the Victorian era, also an art patron, draftsman, and a fine watercolourist. After his death in 1900, 39 volumes of his work was published between 1903 and 1912. Thank you. The Black Brunswicker is an imaginary scene showing a young Prussian Black Brunswicker cavalry officer saying goodbye to his English lover to fight at Napoleon's initial attack at Quatre Bras, which took place the day before the Battle of Waterloo. The evening dress worn by the English girl was modelled by Charles Dickens' daughter Kate and refers to the famous ball given by the Duchess of Richmond on the night before the Battle of Waterloo. In the conflict at Quatre Bras, the Brunswickers suffered catastrophic losses, and the inference is that the young man would very probably have been killed in the battle. The Black Brunswicker marked a watershed in Millais' reputation and propelled him into the position of the nation's most popular painter. The picture was sold for 1,000 guineas, the highest price he had obtained to date. The picture shows a nobleman reluctantly handing over jewels to secure the release of his two daughters from kidnappers who have held them for ransom. The composition compresses seven figures into a tight space and involved meticulous research into the design and fabrication of the dress. According to Millais' son, most of the costumes were made by Millais' wife Effie from a book of design lent to her by Lady Eastlake.
Thank you.